here we have a company that's really taking a role in the industry that is not dissimilar to the role that Facebook had in those days of supercharged, you know, domination and growth. In fact, interestingly, I think, you know, just 2 weeks ago or so, Facebook gained more in one day than any company ever had when they went up $197 billion, which is hard to say and believe. They did that. I suspect that today Nvidia will go up more than that. So we have these records being just shattered by these companies. It isn't the same. It's a chip company, but it's interesting. It's also still run by its founder. It's a company that has, its founder has had a long-term view the entire time, which he is in extraordinary fashion realizing after 30 years of methodical development, in a way that's not dissimilar from how Facebook was at the center of the change in global communications as the dominant company in social media. Nvidia is now increasingly at the center of global, not just communications, but analysis and systems management and computation generally as the central company in the AI revolution in terms of at least dollars. I mean, OpenAI's out there doing the stuff, but these are the guys making the money.
Yeah. Hey, David, you know, first of all, thank you for the notes you sent us this morning. And if you have not yet published them, please publish them somewhere on your social media.
I thought those were not as good as my usual notes.
No, and I'll tell you what, just because for the average investor who wants to get a little perspective, your simple notes here today are very, very helpful. You know, there are some folks out there, David, that are suggesting that AI could be as big or bigger than the internet. Can you help us put some perspective on that?
Well, it's not a crazy statement. I think we don't really know how big or even what AI is. It's still at such an early stage of gestation that we are processing in real time. Even Jen-Hsun Huang, even Sam Altman are processing in real time what this could be. But there's no question that what we're seeing, and I was actually, this is a point that I didn't put in the notes that is you're teeing up. You know, what happened when the internet came along was the entire industry reconfigured around this new opportunity. And we are seeing something exactly like that now for a much, much, much bigger industry, which is in that sense, even more impressive. You know, we have the aggregate market cap of this industry is somewhere getting up close probably to $10 trillion. Maybe it's more than that. I haven't done the math, but that's the range we're talking about. You know, at the time the internet came along, the tech industry in the most broad definition might have been worth $250 billion, $300 billion. I don't know. Maybe I'm a little low there, but it was not over a trillion. And so in a sense, it's more important now than the internet was. If it's true that we are entering a new phase of computation and social change based on computation, which is essentially the way you need to think of it. And this is why it's like the internet, a social change based on computation.
Right.
That's what we're going through again now.
What's the free lunch on this, David Kirkpatrick? I've been looking at the thermodynamics of this. Everybody knows my view on BitDog. I'm not a fan. I think the thermodynamics of it is just bogus. But I don't believe that for AI, but I'm ignorant. I mean, we're talking here about a massive infrastructure build-out, a massive drag on electricity. It's just too much of a free lunch, David Kirkpatrick. What's the, not the dark side, but what's the cost of this AI boom?
There are so many costs, but again, it's something that nobody yet really fully understands. I mean, it's interesting when you heard this crazy thing of Altman going out, supposedly trying to get $7 trillion invested in this arena, you know, which is a ridiculous hyperbolic effort. But it suggests the scale of the resources that are going to be employed here. And yes, from an electricity point, you know, one of the reasons Sam Altman is the biggest investor in one of the fusion startups is because Altman believes that without fusion, without nuclear fusion power, we won't be able to affordably get enough power for AI. That's the kind of things that people in the industry are saying. So I actually think, though, it's a two-sided coin, happily, as the internet was in some ways, that we will get tons of social benefit and actually cost savings and efficiencies out of the application of this technology, which is so expensive to run.
David, my CEO last year had to be Mark Zuckerberg. The way he reversed around from that debacle, Paul's covered this better than me. What's the next step for Mr. Zuckerberg to end the conversation?
Well, obviously he's pivoted fully away from the metaverse in the short term. I do think, you know, one thing he's right about, and you know how critical I am of him, I wrote a piece in Time magazine which was unbelievably negative on their 20th birthday 2 weeks ago.
Mrs. Zuckerberg but wasn't happy.
I called it a tragedy. But you know, they also understand augmented reality in the same way that Apple does. And even though they're not going to have devices as good as Apple's, you know, what's going to be interesting in this AI era is what the interface is going to be. That's one of the key questions that isn't resolved. I think Facebook, Meta, may actually be positioning itself pretty well for the interface of the AI revolution as they pivoted toward augmented reality through Oculus, et cetera. So it's not about the metaverse. It's about some kind of verse that is AI driven, and we're going to have to learn how to interact with it, all of us.